నమస్తే. వెల్కమ్ టు మన టీవీ స్పెషల్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ గురుకుల ఉద్యోగ గైడ్. మరి ఈరోజు మనం డిస్కస్ చేసుకోబోయే టాపిక్ వచ్చి ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్ అండ్ వేదిక్ సివిలైజేషన్. ఈ రెండు విషయాల గురించి మీకు అవగాహన కల్పించడానికి మనతో ఉన్నారు వెంకటేశం షైని, సీనియర్ ఫ్యాకల్టీ ఇన్ హిస్టరీ. మరి వారిని పరిచయం చేసుకుని డీటెయిల్స్లోకి వెళ్దాం. నమస్తే అండి.
నమస్తే.
సో రిగార్డింగ్ గురుకుల, వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్? కెన్ యూ ప్లీజ్ బ్రీఫ్లీ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ అబౌట్ దిస్?
సో రిగార్డింగ్ ఇండియన్ హిస్టరీ ఇన్ గురుకుల, వీ విల్ గెట్ సో మెనీ క్వశ్చన్స్. యాక్చువల్లీ వీ విల్ గెట్, ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ హౌ మెనీ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఇన్ ఇండియన్ హిస్టరీ. సో వీ హ్యావ్ అట్లీస్ట్ మినిమం టు మ్యాక్సిమం 10. దట్స్ వై వితిన్ దీస్ 10 క్వశ్చన్స్ ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ వీ హ్యావ్ టోటల్లీ ఇండియన్ హిస్టరీ సిలబస్. బట్ హియర్ వీ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్, ద ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్. సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ద టాపిక్ విచ్ ఈజ్ ఆస్కింగ్ హియర్. దట్స్ వై ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్ ఇస్ ద మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ సివిలైజేషన్ ఇన్ ఇండియన్ హిస్టరీ. దిస్ ఈజ్ ద ఫస్ట్ సివిలైజేషన్ ఇన్ ఇండియా. సో యాక్చువల్లీ ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఫౌండెడ్ ఇన్ 1921. వెన్ ఎవర్ ది ఎక్స్కవేషన్స్ ఆర్ స్టార్టెడ్ ఇన్ 1921, ఫ్రమ్ దట్ డే ఆన్వర్డ్స్ వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ ది మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ సివిలైజేషన్, దట్ ఈస్ ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్. సో ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద, ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు నో వాట్ ఈస్ ది మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ సివిలైజేషన్. సివిలైజేషన్ మీన్స్ ద డెవలప్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ కల్చర్ అండ్ లివింగ్ స్టైల్. సో వేర్ ఎవర్ ది డెవలప్మెంట్ ఇన్ ద కల్చర్, వేర్ ఎవర్ ది డెవలప్మెంట్ ఇన్ ద లివింగ్ సిస్టమ్ అండ్ లివింగ్ స్టైల్, దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ది సివిలైజేషన్. సో హియర్ వీ హ్యావ్ ది మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ సివిలైజేషన్, దట్ ఈస్ ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్. అండ్ యూ సీ హియర్ ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్ కాంటెంపరీ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ సో మెనీ సివిలైజేషన్స్. సో దెర్ ఆర్ సో మెనీ కాంటెంపరీ సివిలైజేషన్స్. లైక్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ యూ సీ మెసపటోమియా సివిలైజేషన్. మెసపటోమియా సివిలైజేషన్ మీన్స్ ఇరాక్ సివిలైజేషన్. అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ వీ షుడ్ రిమెంబర్ వన్ పాయింట్. సో మ్యాక్సిమమ్ సివిలైజేషన్స్ ఇన్ ద వరల్డ్ అక్కర్డ్ ఆన్ ద బ్యాంక్ ఆఫ్ రివర్స్. ఓకే, ద కాంటెంపరీ సివిలైజేషన్స్ మ్యాక్సిమమ్ దే అక్కర్డ్ ఆన్ ది బ్యాంక్ ఆఫ్ ది రివర్స్. ఎస్పెషల్లీ వి షుడ్ టేక్ మెసపటోమియా సివిలైజేషన్. ఇట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ఇరాక్ సివిలైజేషన్. ఓకే, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఆన్ ది బ్యాంక్ ఆఫ్ యూప్రటిస్ అండ్ టైగ్రస్ రివర్స్. అండ్ ఈజిప్ట్ సివిలైజేషన్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఆన్ ద బ్యాంక్ ఆఫ్ నైల్ రివర్. అండ్ చైనా సివిలైజేషన్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఆన్ ద బ్యాంక్ ఆఫ్ ఓయాంగ్ హో. ఇఫ్ యూ టేక్ మ్యాక్సిమమ్ ఎనీ సివిలైజేషన్, దోస్ ఆర్ అక్కర్డ్ ఆన్ ద బ్యాంక్ ఆఫ్ రివర్స్ ఓన్లీ. అండ్ వన్ సివిలైజేషన్ ఈజ్ డిఫరెంట్ సివిలైజేషన్, దట్ ఈజ్ పర్షియన్ సివిలైజేషన్. పర్షియన్ సివిలైజేషన్ ఈజ్ నాట్ అక్కర్డ్ ఆన్ ది బ్యాంక్ ఆఫ్ రివర్స్. ఇట్ అక్కర్డ్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఓన్లీ ఇన్ హిల్ స్టేషన్స్ అండ్ ప్లేన్స్ ఓన్లీ. సో దట్స్ వై, సో వీ షుడ్ రిమెంబర్ మ్యాక్సిమమ్ సివిలైజేషన్స్, బికాస్ వేర్ ఎవర్ ది వాటర్ దేర్ విల్ బి సివిలైజేషన్. సో మ్యాక్సిమమ్ సివిలైజేషన్స్ ఆర్ అక్కర్డ్ ఆన్ ది బ్యాంక్ ఆఫ్ రివర్. సో ఇండియన్, దట్ ఈస్ ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్. ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్ అక్కడ్ ఆన్ ద బ్యాంక్ ఆఫ్ ఇండస్ రివర్ అండ్ ఇట్స్ ట్రిబ్యూటరీస్. ఓకే, సో హియర్ వాట్ ఆర్ ది ఇండస్ రివర్ అండ్ ఇట్స్ ట్రిబ్యూటరీస్? ఇండస్ రివర్ హ్యాజ్ టోటల్ హియర్ వీ హ్యావ్ 7 రివర్స్. సో దట్ ఈజ్ ఇండస్ రివర్, సరస్వతి రివర్, రావి, చీనాబ్, బియాస్, సట్లేజ్, జీలం అండ్ దట్ ఇస్ సింధు ఫైనలీ. సో దిస్ ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్ ఈజ్ అక్కర్డ్ అమాంగ్ ఆల్ దీస్ రివర్స్. దట్స్ వై ఇట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్. సో యాక్చువల్లీ ఇన్ 1921 హరప్పా ఇస్ ఫౌండెడ్ ఫస్ట్. సో దయారామ్ సహాని హాజ్ గివెన్ ద నేమ్, ఇట్ ఈస్ హరప్పన్ కల్చర్డ్ సివిలైజేషన్. బట్ లేటర్ యునో మ్యాక్సిమమ్ సివిలైజేషన్స్, మ్యాక్సిమమ్ ఏరియాస్ ఇన్ ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్ దర్ ఆర్ 250 ఏరియాస్ ఆర్ ఫౌండెడ్. ద 250 ఏరియాస్ నియర్ అబౌట్ 250 ఏరియాస్ దే ఆర్ సరౌండింగ్ ఆఫ్ ఇండస్ రివర్ అండ్ ఇట్స్ ట్రిబ్యూటరీస్. దట్స్ వై జాన్ మార్షల్ వాజ్ సర్వేయర్ జనరల్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్కియాలజికల్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా, హీ హాజ్ గివెన్ ద నేమ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ హరప్పన్ కల్చర్ సివిలైజేషన్, ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్. has the given the name, that is Indus Valley civilization. That is why so many aspirants will have the doubt, is it Harappan civilization or Indus Valley civilization. But here, first of all, according to Dayaram Sahani views, opinion, it is called Indus Valley civilization. It is Harappan civilization. Later, it has got the name Indus Valley civilization. It has given by John Marshall. So, this is the little bit confusion over the aspirants. They may have this confusion. That is why make it clear. And the origin of civilization of Indus Valley civilization boundaries. What are the boundaries of Indus Valley civilization? So, you see this is on the north, that means in Jammu and Kashmir, Manda is the northeast boundary of Indus Valley civilization, and in the south, Daimabad in Maharashtra, it is the southern boundary of Indus Valley civilization, and west, Sukta Jandar nearby Baluchistan. So, it is a west boundary, and east, Alangipur, it is in UP. So, these are the boundaries of Indus Valley civilization. The total area of civilization, that is 10 million square kilometers, that means 1 crore square kilometers. This is the area which is occurred by Indus Valley civilization. So, this Indus Valley civilization, near about I told already, it is occurred in 250 areas. For example, Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, Kalibangan, Lothal, Sukta Jandar, Chanudaro, Dholvira, there are maximum 250 areas. 250 areas are occurred. So, first of all, you have to see the Harappa. Harappa, it is called the granary city. Harappa is called granary city. Why? Because here the great granaries are occurred. 12 granaries. We should remember 12 granaries. Granaries means here godowns, warehousings. So, we can say Dhanyagaram. We can say that is Dhanyagaram. So, warehouses, 12 warehouses are occurred. So, they are founded in Harappa area. That is why it is called a granary city. Harappa is called granary city. So, and second city, that is Mohenjo-daro. Second city, it is Mohenjo-daro. Mohenjo-daro is the greatest, it is a big city among all 250 cities. It is the biggest city, that is Mohenjo-daro. So, it in Sindh language, Mohenjo-daro means in Sindh language it is called the mound of dead. So, Mrutula Dibba, mound of dead means Mrutula Dibba. That is why, so Mohenjo-daro, it is called, it is the meaning of meaning in the Sindh language, that is mound of dead, and it is most density town. Among all 250 towns, so it is the most density city or town. So, here the great bath is founded in Mohenjo-daro. We should remember what are the monuments, what are the great things are founded in these excavations in these towns. That is why we should remember, that is the great bath. It is like a swimming pool. It is a great construction used bricks, and it has two canals. So, one canal, it is for hot water, one canal for the cold water. That is why this is a greatness, great engineering technology of these Indus Valley people. And here Pashupati idol, the idol, that is Vigraham, Pashupati idol is founded in Mohenjo-daro. Why? Because you see maximum the historians are concluded, they are saying that Pashupati is one of the god worshipped by Indus Valley people. That is why that Pashupati idol is founded in Mohenjo-daro, as well as one more idol, that is dancing woman, naked dancing woman. It is a copper metal, pure copper metal idol. It is also founded in Mohenjo-daro, as well as a terracotta cart. So, bullock cart, like a terracotta cart, also it is founded in Mohenjo-daro. So, and Mohenjo-daro, it is affected by Indus and its tributaries floods 7 times. It is affected by 7 times floods of Indus river and its tributaries. So, and one more, next, Lothal. Lothal is the harbor. It is in Gujarat. It is the biggest town in Gujarat. It has a harbor. This harbor, that means in Gujarat, Kutch, where is the Kutch Gulf, there is this Lothal area. So, it has a artificial harbor. Lothal has a artificial harbor. It is constructed by Indus Valley people. So, it is the main harbor of Indus Valley business and trading. So, we got the Persian seals in this Lothal area. The historians, archaeological department founded that seals, like stamps seals, because of that seals belonging to Persia. That Persian seals, they are founded. That is why they are decided, yes, Indus Valley people have done the business with Persia. So, that is why, so Lothal has a lot of importance, and Lothal is one and only city in Indus Valley civilization that is cultivated rice. So, Lothal and also one more town, Rangapur, both are cultivated rice in Indus Valley civilization. Mainly Indus Valley civilization, the crops, barley, wheat, etcetera, but no town has cultivated the rice in Indus Valley civilization. That is why here Lothal and Rangapur, they cultivated rice. We should remember this point, because we will get the question, which town or which area cultivated rice in Indus Valley civilization, that is Lothal. Along with Lothal, also Rangapur. And so, one more town, Kalibangan, it is in Rajasthan. So, we should remember, we have 250 places. Among them, we are discussing about the important cities only. That is why Kalibangan, it is founded in Rajasthan. It is on the bank of Ghaggar river, it is in Rajasthan. So, Kalibangan means it a black bangles. So, black bangles, and mother goddess, which is the important god in or goddess in Indus Valley civilization, that is mother goddess. That mother goddess idol is founded in Indus Valley, is Kalibangan area. So, and Kalibangan has the black beads industries. There are black beads industries, and the biggest agricultural land, biggest agricultural cultivated area, the biggest land is appeared in Kalibangan. That is why, so one and only town or city in Arapa, in Indus Valley civilization cultivated in biggest area. So, we founded that biggest area in Kalibangan. That is why, so beads industry and agriculture, big agriculture fields are founded in Kalibangan area, and these are some of important areas and features of Indus Valley civilization. What are the features? What kind of features are there? You see, Indus Valley civilization, it is totally estimated civilization, because before 1921, we have only Vedic civilization. Before 1921, we have only Vedic civilization. So, the historians decided that in Vedic civilization, Vedic civilization has the sources, written sources. Vedas are the written sources to Vedic civilization. But here, Indus Valley civilization has no any kind of written sources. So, whenever the excavations are started in 1921, under the leadership of John Marshall, it is founded. There are so many seals, so many monuments, parts, figures like this. Because of these monuments, because of these seals, the historians are expected, estimated Indus Valley civilization. That is why we should remember, before 1921, we have Vedic civilization. Vedic civilization, it is it has written sources, but Indus Valley civilization has no any kind of written sources. That is why it is only estimated civilization. That estimated system, how they estimated? By carbon dating system. So, this is also called carbon dating system. It is the system also called C14 system, carbon dating system and C14 system. So, we may get question like this. They can ask which kind of method used for the estimating of Indus Valley civilization, that is carbon dating system and C14 system, and some circles of tree stems, circles of tree stems also there. This is called dendrochronology system. Whenever the using of circles of stems of tree, that is also called dendrochronology system. That is why this is Indus Valley civilization, most of all estimated civilization. So, what are the features? Here it is urban civilization, Indus Valley civilization totally urban civilization. How would you like to say, how we can say is it the urban civilization? Because you see the town planning, because of town planning it is estimating it is urban civilization. So, what was the town planning? So, generally the towns will be constructed as per the plan. For example, if you go to villages, villages cannot be constructed as per the plan, because they have zigzag, they have roads and streets, they will be zigzag in zigzag system. But here it is the planned town plan is very very planned, that is why so it is called urban civilization. So, it has grid planning system. This is the question we should remember, we should point out this grid system. Grid system means the junctions, centers, junctions. For example, Indus Valley towns having the main roads from north to south, the main roads from north to south, and subways, sub roads, they are from west to east and east to west. Wherever these roads are going to join, wherever they are going to meet, that is called a junction system, that is also grid system. So, all these roads and roads constructed as per the plan, and the most important construction of Indus Valley civilization, that is the drainage system. Okay. So, if you see in the towns, we will have the good planned drainage system, underground drainage, they have used, they constructed the underground drainage system. So, that is why underground drainage system, it will be in towns only, and they used the burnt bricks, because a kaljana itkalu. So, burnt bricks, they use burnt bricks. So, we should understand the technology in those days. That is why these drainage system, road system, so all are as per the planning system. That is why this is called urban civilization. Okay. And what are the social conditions? So, Indus Valley civilization, it is the matriarchic society, it is called matriarchic society. Matriarchic society means Matru Swamika Vyavastha. So, Matru Swamika, that is called matriarchic society. So, here mother is the head of the family, mother is the head of the family, she dominated the families, and woman has great status, woman has a great status, because you see in Indus Valley civilization, it is matriarchic society, woman has great status, mother dominated, and also mother goddess. So, as per these information, we are estimating, we are saying that it is 100% so matriarchic society. Okay. And woman has great status along with the male here, that is why so we can say this is a female dominated system, and they have given importance to beauty, because Indus Valley people, they have different kinds of, they use different kinds of beauty systems. For example, they have long hair, men and women have long hair, and they used body lotions and hair oils, and also they used lipsticks. So, you see casual perfumes, we can expect, because villagers, they cannot use this kind of beautician systems, because lipsticks, the village people cannot use lipsticks. The village people cannot use body lotions, but of course, today they may can, they can use, we do not know that, but in Indus Valley civilization, they use this kind of lipsticks, casuals, perfumes and body lotions, because this is the feature of urban people. That is why we may expect this is urban civilization. So, and these people playing the entertainment programs and amusement programs. What are the amusement programs of Indus Valley people? Okay. Here dice, they used to play dice. Dice means here pachikalu. So, generally we can see pachikalu in Mahabharata, we have this kind of play. So, that is dice. So, it is used to, it is one of entertainment program, one of the playing program of Indus Valley people, and also chess, hunting, wrestling. So, etcetera, amusement programs were there in Indus Valley civilization. And so, what is political system? What is political system of Indus Valley civilization? Okay. So, actually this is estimated civilization, that is why any kind of witness is not there. any kind of sources, sources are not there regarding political system of Indus Valley civilization. That is why historians are decided, that it has no any kind of political system. We should remember, in Vedic civilization we have political system, we have Jain system, but here in Indus Valley civilization there is no any kind of political system, but there are some Purohita idols, are founded. So, maybe Purohita maintain the society, but except this thing, so we have no any kind of sources regarding the political system of Indus Valley people. And regarding religious conditions, what are the religious conditions? So, earlier I told, so they worshipped mother goddess and Pashupati. We understand the main god of Indus Valley civilization, that is mother goddess. We will have the question, confusing question, what is that, which god is or which gods are worshipped by Indus Valley civilization? A, mother goddess Pashupati. B, mother god, Pashupati mother goddess. C, Pashupati. D, mother goddess. If they give like this multiple choice question, A, mother goddess Pashupati, B, Pashupati mother goddess, C, mother goddess, D, Pashupati. If they give this kind of question, we will have much confusion. Why? Because generally all these gods are there, mother goddess also there, Pashupati also there. So, all these gods are available in Indus Valley civilization, but the sequence, we should remember sequence. First of all, we should identify mother goddess only, followed Pashupati. This is the correct answer, but if they give first Pashupati, if they give mother goddess later, it is wrong. That is why we should remember, we should be careful while finding the question, that is mother goddess first and Pashupati second. That is why this is the most important factor, most important question to understand, to remember regarding Indus Valley civilization. And they worshipped papal tree, the tree also worshipped by the Indus Valley civilization people, that is papal tree, or we can say Ravi Chettu. So, it is worshipped by Indus Valley people, and they worshipped bird, also. So, that is a bird, dove, pigeon, also worshipped by Indus Valley people. And they worshipped animal, that animal is a humped bull and humpless bull. So, whenever we are saying about Indus Valley civilization, we can find the humped bulls. There are so many idols of, so many pictures of humped bulls. That is why this is the most important point regarding Indus Valley civilization, that is they worshipped humped and humpless bulls, and they worshipped also, snakes. Snakes also worshipped by Indus Valley people, and they worshipped organs of women and gents, male. They worshipped organs of male and woman. That is why this is also worshipping system of Indus Valley people. Finally, mother goddess, Pashupati, dove, humped bull, humpless bull, and papal tree, etcetera, worshipped by Indus Valley people. And what are the economical conditions? So, these Indus Valley people, the main profession of Indus Valley people, agriculture followed by cattle breeding. Here also we have confusion. So, because you see, agriculture is the main profession of Indus Valley people, then cattle breeding. But regarding Vedic civilization, cattle breeding is first, agriculture is second. Okay, we should understand this point. In Indus Valley civilization, agriculture is first, cattle breeding second. But in Vedic civilization, cattle breeding is first, agriculture is second. So, this is the main variation. That is why here the main crop of Indus Valley people, that is agriculture and also cattle breeding. So, the main crops which are produced, which are cultivated by Indus Valley people, that is wheat, barley, etcetera. So, already earlier I told, wheat, barley, along with them we have the rice, Lothal, Rangapur, there is a rice productivity. Okay, that is why we should remember. And next, one and only civilization in the world cultivated, produced cotton, which is one and only crop, cultivated by Indus Valley people, that is cotton. Because in contemporary civilizations, there was no cotton in cotton cultivation, cotton producing except Indus Valley civilization. That is why here cotton also cultivated by Indus Valley people. And what are the economical conditions? They know all the economical conditions here means you see regarding the animals, they know all the animals except horse and lion. Okay. So, which is we may have the question, which is the animal not known by Indus Valley people? That is especially horse. So, you know, in Sukta Jandar they found a horse skeleton, but because of these reason only we should not decide Indus Valley people knows that horse, but we should not decide like that. But maximum historians are saying that horse is not known by Indus Valley civilization, and along with the horse, lion also is not known by these people. And there was no coining system, coins are not introduced, there are no coins, only the exchanging of goods, that is called barter system. Barter system means if we are giving one thing, for example, giving rice, they will give us wheat. If we are giving some what we can say vegetable, they will give some dal. That is why this is totally, it is depending on the barter system, exchanging of the goods. So, and here one more thing we should remember, the transaction, the economical transportation totally on these bullock carts. Bullock cart was main transportation vehicle, that is a bullock cart, and they cultivated all kinds of vegetables, they used all kinds of non-veg and vegetarians, and they have taken milk products also. That is why this is a totally information regarding their financial and financial system. And literature, what is a literature of Indus Valley civilization? Here literature means there are no kind of any kind of books, any kind of written sources. So, Bialak, if we get any kind of written source regarding Indus Valley civilization, we will get more information regarding Indus Valley civilization. That is why, so there are literature means the script, especially we should say about the script. Their script, which is founded in Indus Valley civilization excavations, that is pictography, Chitralipi. So, pictography, there are 400 script letters in Indus Valley civilization. They found 400 script, all that letters are looking like a fish shape and some lines model. So, fish, how we are looking fish. So, like these kind of pictures are there, near about 400 letters, that is why it is called pictography. But writing of these letters, first line from left to right, second line from right to left, third line from left to right. So, like this, it is like a snake, how it is going snake like this. So, first line left to right, second line right to left like this, it is looking like a snake. That is why it is called Sarpalekana Lipi, also called Bestroprothan, it is called Sarpalekana Lipi. So, we should remember what is the script of Indus Valley civilization, that is pictography. How they write means that is called Sarpalekana system, Bestroprothan. So, this is actually so many people tried to know to find what is correct meaning of these letters, this script, but unfortunately nobody has founded about the meaning of these script. That is why, so we are not knowing the much information regarding Indus Valley civilization. And Indus Valley civilization, how it is closed, how it is ended, how it is declined, what are the reasons to declining of Indus Valley civilization. So, especially there are so many reasons are there, but we have to take three reasons. That is one, so Aryans invasion, first one Aryans invasions. Aryans are attacked on Indus Valley civilization, because of that attacking, that invasions Indus Valley civilization is closed. It was declined, and their king. But in some of books they are in some of literature, Aryan's god Purandara. Aryan's god Purandara, like Indra. So he has a name Purandara. So Purandara destroyed. He has done destroying of Indus Valley towns. But this is a maybe story. But the original cause, that is Aryan invasions, and second, floods of Indus and its tributaries. So here, actually Indus Valley civilization occurred surrounding of Indus rivers and its tributaries. That's why, because of their floods, it may be closed. It may be ended. Why? Because Mohenjo-daro affected by Indus river floods, as well as it has affected by seven times. It is affected for seven times. That's why, as well as remaining all towns may be affected by Indus river and its tributaries. And one more earthquakes. So these are most important reasons regarding Indus Valley civilization. Okay, and here in Indus Valley civilization, people, what kind of race they are. That's why Indus Valley people belonging to six human races. Indus Valley people belonging to six human races. First one, that is Australoids. Second, Proto-Australoids. Third, Mongoloids. Fourth, Mediterranean. Fifth, Alphanoids. Sixth, Negrotes. Once again, so Australoids, Proto-Australoids, Mongoloids, Mediterranean, Alphanoids, and Negritos. So maximum Indus Valley people, so belonging to Mediterranean, they are maximum Mediterranean race, because Mediterranean looking like looking like black color, having big nose and having 5.5-5.6 height. So this is these features are looking like our Dravidians, because the Mediterranean they may be looking like 5.5-6.7 height and a black color, and having big nose and a big forehead, and the strong legs also. So these features these are the features of Dravidians also. That's why historians have decided the original people, who are original people of Indus Valley civilization, that is Dravidians. That's why. So here, Indus Valley civilization people are called Dasyas by Aryans. They are called Dasyas and Aryans. So Aryans are called Indus Valley people. Dasyas means slaves. Dasilu, they call like Dasilu, Dasyas. That means slaves. So whenever Aryans are attacked on Indus Valley civilization people, they migrated to South India. So Indus Valley people settle in South India only. That's why today we can decide that. So North Indian people belonging to Aryan race, South Indian people belonging to Dravidian race. So this is the final conclusion. The people who are stayed in Indus Valley civilization, they are called Dravidians. That may be Dasyas. So this is the conclusion of Indus Valley civilization. Okay, so
ipudu Vedic civilization gurinchi telusukundam.
Yeah, so after Indus Valley civilization we have Vedic civilization. So just regarding duration, so Indus Valley civilization, there are different opinions during the period of Indus Valley civilization, but finally decided that 2500 BC to 1500 BC. This is final concluded date, because there are 3500 to 1500, 3000 to 1500, there are different opinions, but finally the historians have decided that the Indus Valley civilization period from 2500 BC to 1500 BC, this is totally Indus Valley civilization. So now we are going to a Vedic civilization. We are going to discuss about Vedic civilization. So Vedic civilization is from 1500 BC to 600 BC. Vedic civilization is from 1500 BC to 600 BC. So basically we have Vedic civilization has two kinds. It has two kinds. But according to historians, how many civilizations in India? If anybody raises this question, how many civilizations are in India? So we should say two civilizations. Basically, we should say two civilizations: one, Indus Valley civilization, and two, Vedic civilization. Again, Vedic civilization has two kinds. So, but don't confuse anybody, because regarding civilizations in high school studies, we will have so many confusions, so many confusions. But here, no need to worry, no need to have any confusion. Why? Because Indus Valley civilization, it is one civilization, and Vedic civilization also one civilization. Means the basic civilizations are in India, two civilizations. But later, these Vedic civilization divide into two civilizations. But totally we have three, but basically two. This is the main thing we should remember. We should find it, okay? But don't have any confusion. So basically we have two civilizations, but in fact we have three civilizations. That means Vedic has two civilizations, that is early Vedic civilization and later Vedic civilization. So early Vedic civilization, later Vedic civilization. Early Vedic civilization is from 1500 to 1000 BC. So it is from 1500 to 1000 BC, and later Vedic 1000 to 600 BC. So we should write. So one, early Vedic, it is from 1500 to 1000. Later Vedic 1000 to 600. So what is Vedic civilization? What is the meaning of civilization? The civilization which is occurred in the period of Vedas. The civilization which is occurred in Vedas, that is called Vedic civilization. The civilization which is in Vedas, that is called Vedic civilization. Okay. So here we have four Vedas. We have four Vedas, that is Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda, Atharvana Veda. We have four Vedas. Okay. Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda, Atharvana Veda. So Rig Veda consists slokas. Rig Veda consists slokas. Slokas means what kind of slokas? While doing krat, while doing yajna, yaga, sacrifices, what are the slokas we have to sing? That is slokas. So Rig Veda consists of slokas, and Yajur Veda consists of karma kanda. Yajur Veda consists of karma kanda. Karma kanda means here, karma kanda means while doing krat, what kind of karma we have to do, what kind of things we have to do, that is called karma kanda. And Sama Veda consists of music. Here music, regarding music, which is the oldest book in the world, regarding the music, which is the oldest book in the world, that is Janda Avesta Persians book, that is Janda Avesta, it is the oldest book of music in the world. But here Sama Veda also describing about music. So music means here not this kind of Rajkoti and some other Rahman music, that is not music here. The music means here, so what kind of rhythm while singing the slokas, when doing the krat and yaga, so what kind of rhythm, what kind of style, what kind of rhythmic style we have to maintain, we have to sing, that is called music here. So that is why Sama Veda consists music. And Atharvana Veda, it is Tantra, Mantra, Black Magics and also Ayurveda. So Atharvana consists of Tantra, Mantra and like Ayurveda also. And so what is the meaning of Veda? We should know first. What is the meaning of Veda? Veda, the word derived from Vid Dhatu. Veda, it is the word derived from Vid Dhatu. Vid means so to know, telusukovadam. Vid means to know, telusukovadam. So, and Veda means knowledge, wisdom, jnanamu. So, Veda means the knowledge, wisdom or jnanamu. So, actually who wrote Vedas? Mari Vedal never rasaru. Who wrote Vedas? Actually Vedas are apaurusheya. No human kind has written the Vedas. Mari Vedas evaru rayanappudu ela vachayi, etlo vachayi? So, that is a no human kind has written. So that's why apaurusheya apaura, that means paurulu rayanatvanti ante manavulu rayanatvanti vedalu mari ela vachayante, that is the god expressed vedas to brahma. First of all, the god expressed the vedas to brahma. Okay, brahma, that's why he is having four heads. That's why that four heads are indicating four vedas. That's vedas are indicating four vedas. That's why first of all brahma, god taught vedas to brahma, then brahma he taught to his disciples. So from guru to shishya these vedas are transformed, it has transferred, then finally parashara, the vedas reach to parashara. This is like guru shishya parampara, generation to generation. So finally it's gone to parashara, then parashara taught vedas to his son vyasa. Parashara taught vedas to his son vyasa, then vyasa composed the vedas, vyasa written the veda, that's why he became veda vyasa, that's why he became veda vyasa. That's why so vedas are not written by any human kind, finally veda vyasa composed to vedas. So this is the information regarding the vedas. So how many types of vedas? Every veda has four types. So every veda has four parts, we can say parts, it's clear. So every veda has four parts, that is brahmanas, samhitas, aranyakas, upanishads. So brahmanas, samhitas, aranyakas, upanishads, whenever if you understand the vedas we should know these four parts. Then upanishads, the final upanishads, they can say karma kanda, atma, paramatma, soul, super soul, rebirth. So regarding all this information in upanishads, okay, that's why the vedas are four parts, it has four parts, and every veda has six vedangas, these are called vedangas. So it has vedangas means if you want to understand veda, if you want to learn veda, then we should know the six vedangas, that is kalpa, shiksha, nirukta, vyakarana, chandasu, jyotishya. So these are the six vedangas. So what is the use of these vedangas? Whenever you know these vedangas, then only you can understand the vedas. But simply if you read veda, we cannot understand. Whenever you are knowing these six angas, that's called vedangas. That's why so these are called vedangas. And there are shat darshan. So darshan means shat darshan means for moksha. Shat darshan means we have six visions, these are called six darshans. That means what is the use of these six darshans, shat darshans means so when you want moksha, then you have to know this six kind of shat darshans. Moksha means, what is the meaning of moksha? What is the meaning of moksha? Moksha means not having rebirth, that is called moksha, not having rebirth, that is called moksha. So moksha means so we are going to heaven. Whenever you are going, we are reaching to heaven, then you don't have any rebirth, that is the moksha. If you want to go to moksha, you should know shat darshan, that is a sankhya darshan. It is explained by, described, composed by Kapila. So Kapiludu, he was great saint, great knowledgeable person, great intellectual. So sankhya darshan by Kapila, and nyaya darshan Gautama, and yoga darshan Patanjali. So right now we are knowing that yoga, that is described by Patanjali, and vaisheshika darshan Kanadudu. Kanada, you know, vaisheshika, Kanadudu, he told about anuvulu. ఇప్పుడు ఈ భూమి మీద మానవుడు ఎలా పుట్టాడు అనే కాన్సెప్ట్లో పదము, ఒక పదార్థము అనే పాయింట్, ఒక కణము అయిన అణువు అనే పాయింట్ ఏదైతుందో, లేదా కణము అనే పాయింట్ ఏదైతుందో, దట్ ఈజ్ కణాదుడు, మనకు అక్కడ నుంచి వచ్చింది. అందుకే సో కణాదుడు ఈ డిస్క్రైబ్ అబౌట్ వైశేషిక దర్శన్ అండ్ పూర్వ మీమాంస, దిస్ ఇస్ బై సో జైమిని, అండ్ ఉత్తర మీమాంస ఇట్ ఈస్ బై బాదరాయణ. So these are the shat darshan. When you want to go to moksha, you should know these shat darshan, six darshans, and Rigveda. Rigveda is explaining about the yugas. Rigveda explaining about the Veda yugas. That is, we have four yugas. That is, Kruta, Treta, Dwapara, Kali Yuga. This is the knowledge regarding the Vedas. But some of the students will have the doubt. Kondama doubt ostundi. So, we will have the doubt, sir. Ivani mem chadavali avasaram ante. This is the regarding the knowledge of Vedas. After completion of these knowledge, these points, we can go for directly the civilization of Vedic. That is why, first of all, this is the introduction regarding literature of a Vedic system. That is why, so here four Vedas, that Krita, sorry, Yugas, Krita Yuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, Kali Yuga. So, Krita Yuga, this is the period of we can say we have Dashavatara actually. So, we have Dashavatara. So, in this Dashavatara, Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, Narasimha, Vamana. These five, Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, Narasimha, Vamana. So, these five avatar forms of Vishnu. So, they recently we have question. So, which is first form of Dashavatara? Which is first form of Dashavatara? So, we have confusion. We know 10 forms of Vishnu. So, that is Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, Narasimha, Vamana. So, in this these five characters for five forms in Krita Yuga, and Treta Yuga we have Sri Rama and Parashurama.
Right.
In, okay.
Okay. Caller,
yeah, yeah. Okay.
Hello. Hello.
Hello. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, and you are talking to?
Zakira Begum, sir. Badradri district.
Zakira Begum, sir. Where are you?
Yes, ma'am.
Badradri.
Badradri district.
Okay, and Venkatesham Garunaru, senior faculty history lo, me Sunday went to Argan.
Okay, ma'am. Good evening, sir.
Good evening, ma'am. Chapani.
Sir, I Gurukul exam lo, maku history nunchi A top cover ayithe, sir.
Chapani, malok sir, chapani.
History nunchi A topics ustayi, manaku syllabus lo em ledu, history
of Indian history annaru,
A topics ustayo ardham kavatledu.
Yeah, yeah. Good. So, ఇండియన్ హిస్టరీ అన్నప్పుడు ఇక్కడ స్పెసిఫిక్గా మనకు తెలంగాణ పబ్లిక్ సర్వీస్ కమిషన్ వారి సిలబస్ ప్రకారం మనకు ప్రిస్క్రైబ్డ్ ఏం చెప్పలేదు పర్ఫెక్ట్గా, బట్ దే సెట్ దట్ ఏంటంటే కల్చర్ హెరిటేజర్ ఆర్కిటెక్చర్ ఆర్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియన్ హిస్టరీ అన్నారు. ఇది మీరు చూసారు కదా. సో ఆర్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియన్ హిస్టరీ అన్నారు కాబట్టి ఇక్కడ మనం చెప్పాల్సింది ఏంటంటే టోటల్ ఇండియన్ హిస్టరీ. ఇది ఏదో ఇది ఇచ్చారు కదా ఇట్లా అని మనం ఫీల్ అవ్వాల్సిన అవసరం లేదు. బట్ టోటల్ ఇండియన్ హిస్టరీ ఫ్రమ్ ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్ టు ఫ్రమ్ ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్ టు 1947. మనం ఇక్కడ మూడు రకాల హిస్టరీలు చదవాల్సిందే. సో ఏన్షియంట్ హిస్టరీ, మిడివల్ హిస్టరీ అండ్ మోడర్న్ హిస్టరీ. దీస్ త్రీ హిస్టరీ వీ షుడ్ ఫాలో. అంతే, ఈ మూడు చదవాల్సిందే. కాకపోతే ఏంటంటే ఇన్ డెప్త్ అవసరం లేదమ్మా, మనం బ్రీఫ్గా చదువుకోవాల్సిందే.
రైట్, థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్ అండి జాకిరా బేగం గారు. రైట్, ఇప్పుడు మనకి వేదిక సివిలైజేషన్ కంప్లీట్ అయిన తర్వాత టైం ఉంటే కనుక జైనిజం గురించి కూడా మాట్లాడుకుందాం. ఓకే, ఓకే, ప్లీజ్ కంటిన్యూ.
ఓకే, ఓకే. సో నౌ యు సీ, ఇన్ త్రేతాయుగంలో ధర్మము, కృతయుగంలో ధర్మం నాలుగు పదాలు అంటారు, త్రేతాయుగంలో ధర్మం మూడు పదాలు అంటారు, ద్వాపరయుగంలో ధర్మం రెండు పదాలు అంటారు, కలియుగంలో ధర్మము ఒక పదం అంటారు. మనం గుర్తుపెట్టుకోవాల్సింది అంటే సరే, ఈ ధర్మాలు కాకుండా కృతయుగంలో ఐదు అవతారాలు, అండ్ త్రేత కన్సిస్ట్స్ టూ అవతార, టూ ఫార్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ విష్ణు, దట్ ఈస్ శ్రీరామ, పరశురామ, ద్వాపర దట్ ఈస్ కృష్ణ, అండ్ కలియుగ బుద్ధ అండ్ కల్కి. సో కల్కి ఈజ్ నాట్ కంప్లీటెడ్, కల్కి ఈజ్ ఆయన రాలేదు, ఇంకా వస్తాడు, ఫ్యూచర్ రావచ్చేమో. సో ఇప్పటికి మాత్రం బుద్ధుని వరకు మనకు కంప్లీట్ అయ్యి. సో కొంతమంది బుద్ధుడు నైన్త్ అవతారంలో ఎట్లున్నాడు మరి ఆయన బుద్ధిజం కదంటే, ఎస్, మన గుప్తుల పీరియడ్లో బ్రాహ్మణిజం సిస్టానికి సంబంధించి ఏంటంటే ఈ బుద్ధిజాన్ని అనగదొక్కే ప్రక్రియలో ఈ బుద్ధుణ్ణి ఈ 10 ఫామ్స్లో కలిపేశారు. 10 ఫామ్స్లో 9th ఫాము బుద్ధ అవుతున్నాడు. కాబట్టి దీనివల్ల ఏమవుతుందంటే ఇన్ ద పీరియడ్ ఆఫ్ గుప్తాస్ బుద్ధిజం గోయింగ్ టు డిక్లైన్, బికాజ్ బుద్ధ హ్యాస్ మెన్షన్ ఇన్ 10 అవతార్ ఆఫ్ విష్ణు, దట్స్ వై ఈ హ్యాస్ యాక్యుపైడ్ ఇన్ 9th ప్లేస్. సో దట్ ఈస్ రిగార్డింగ్ ద ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ వేదాస్ అండ్ వేదిక్ సివిలైజేషన్. వేదిక్ సివిలైజేషన్ ఆల్సో కాల్డ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఆర్యన్ సివిలైజేషన్. వేదిక్ సివిలైజేషన్ మనం ఆర్యన్ సివిలైజేషన్ కూడా అంటున్నాము. సో it is also called Aryan civilization. Why? Because so Vedic civilization totally it's belonging to the Aryans. That's why it is called Aryan civilization. Aryans, what is the meaning of Aryans? Aryans means the people who are having wisdom, who are having knowledge. That's why Arya. What is the meaning of Arya? So who is having knowledge, who is having wisdom, that is called so Arya. One more meaning also there, Arya, Aryans, that is noble people. Noble people means knowing all things, so having knowledge, that is Aryans. And the Vedic civilization, it is also called Aryan civilization. So who are Aryans? So where from they, what was the native place of Aryans, where they came from, var ekkada nunchi vacharu ana kada mana point baa gurtu pettukovali. The various areas, various native places are there according to historians. So regarding native places of Aryans, there are different opinions. And first Balagangadhar Tilak, idi baa gurtu pettukovali. So Balagangadhar Tilak, he described that Aryans came from Arctic pole. Arctic pole means, so we have north pole. North pole of this world is called Arctic pole. So they came from Arctic pole. Okay, so where he described, so when he was in Mandalay jail, he wrote the book Arctic Poem of Vedas. Balagangadhar Tilak wrote Arctic Poem of Vedas. In this book he described about the nativity of or native place of Aryans. That's why according to Balagangadhar Tilak, the native place of these Aryans, that is Arctic pole. And next to Dayanand Saraswati. So regarding Dayanand Saraswati, he told that Tibet, Aryans came from Tibet. And Max Muller, so Eurasia, Max Muller opinion was Eurasia. Eurasia means the central place, that central place between Asia and Europe, this is Eurasia. So according to Max Muller, Aryans came from Eurasia. And the great historian Romila Thapar, she told that Baluchistan. That's why totally whatever the opinion of historians, there are so many opinions, but we are taking little bit important information, that's only, that's why, that's why. So here what is the language, what is the language of Indus Valley people? So they have spoken Indo-European language, they have spoken Indo-European language. Indo-European language means nothing but Sanskrit. But you see what kind of language spoken by Indus Valley people? Maybe this question will be there. What kind of language used by Indus Valley people? That is no language. Indus Valley people, what kind of language used? So there is no answer, because regarding language of Indus Valley, there is no any kind of source. So here the Aryans used the Sanskrit. This is also called Indo-European language. So Sanskrit belonging to, it has the relationship with English, Latin, Spanish, so Lithuanian. So it has the relation, Sanskrit relation with these kind of languages. That's why, so this is language of Aryans is called Sanskrit or Indo-European language. And where the Aryans are settled, where was the place where they settled, that is called Aryavartanam. That is called Aryavartanam. It is also called Saptasil.
Mara call chudandi. Hello.
Okay, okay.
Hello.
Hello. Artha matala.
Yeah, namaste andi, mee peru?
Na peru Sampat andi, Aaleru, Yadadri jilla.
Okay, Sampat garu, Venkatesham garu anto unnaru, mee doubt ento adigi.
Artha matala.
Line lo unnaru, maatladandi.
Hello.
Chepandi babu.
సార్ సార్ నమస్కారం సార్.
నమస్తే
సార్. ఇలా నాకు ఒకటి డౌట్ ఏంటంటే, ఇప్పుడు సొసైటీ కల్చర్ సివిలైజేషన్ ఆర్ట్స్ అండ్ లిటరేచర్ మనకు ఒక పార్ట్ ఇచ్చారు కదా సార్, ఇలా దాంట్లో ఇండియన్ తెలంగాణ వేరు వేరు ఇచ్చారు. ఇప్పుడు ఇండియన్ సంబంధించిన దాంట్లో ఇప్పుడు మొత్తం మనం ఎక్కడి నుంచి ఎక్కడ వరకు చదవాలి, ఎక్కడ ఎన్ని మార్కులు వస్తాయి దీని మీద సార్, ఒక డౌట్ ఉంది మాకు. రెండోది ఏంటంటే, ఇప్పుడు మీరు హరప్ప గురించి చెప్పారు కదా సార్, హరప్ప గురించి రాజస్థాన్ అంటే కాళీబంగాను, ఉత్తరప్రదేశ్ కాళీబంగా, రాజస్థాన్ ఇట్లా ఉన్నాయి కదా సార్, అవి జునాధార్ అని, వాటిలో ఏ నది తీరాన అనేది కొన్ని క్వశ్చన్ ఒకసారి ప్రీవియస్ లో అడిగింది సార్, కొంచెం దాని గురించి మాకు క్లారిఫై చేయండి సార్.
ఇప్పుడు ఫస్ట్ మీరు అడిగారు సిలబస్ ఏంటి అన్నారు, అందులో సిలబస్ అంటే మీకు మీకు ఎయిత్ టోటల్గా జనరల్ స్టడీస్లో మీకు 12 పార్ట్స్ ఉన్నాయి, 12 చాప్టర్స్ ఉన్నట్లున్నాయి అంతే కదా. సో అందులో 8th లో ఇండియన్ హిస్టరీ యాజ్ వెల్ అస్ తెలంగాణ హిస్టరీ ఉంది. సో టోటల్గా ఒక 10-12 క్వశ్చన్స్ వరకు ఈ ఇండియన్ హిస్టరీ అండ్ తెలంగాణ హిస్టరీలో వచ్చే అవకాశం ఉంటుంది. కాబట్టి మనకు 12 మార్క్స్ సంబంధించినటువంటి ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ హిస్టరీ నుండి ఏమొస్తుంది. ఇప్పుడు సిలబస్ చూస్తే వ్యాస్ట్గా ఉంది, మార్క్స్ మాత్రం కొద్దిగా ఉన్నాయి. కాబట్టి ఇక్కడ కన్ఫ్యూజన్ ఏంటంటే మరి ఇంత సిలబస్, ఇండియన్ హిస్టరీ అంటే దాదాపు ఒక 20 చాప్టర్స్ ఉంటాయి, 20 చాప్టర్స్ ఉంటాయి. అదేవిధంగా తెలంగాణ హిస్టరీ అంటే కూడా దాదాపు మీకు ఒక 15 చాప్టర్స్ వరకు మనకు అట్లీస్ట్ ఒక 10-12 చాప్టర్స్ మనకు ఉన్నాయి. ఈ రెండింటి కలిపితే మాకు మనకు 10-12 క్వశ్చన్స్ వచ్చే అవకాశం ఉంటుంది. కాబట్టి మనం ఇక్కడ ఇన్ బ్రీఫ్గా చదవాల్సింది తప్ప డెప్త్గా పోవాల్సినటువంటి అవసరం లేదు. ఇంతకుముందు మీరు అడిగారు ఏ నది ఒడ్డున ఏ టౌన్స్ వచ్చాయని, ఇంత డీప్గా మిమ్మల్ని అడిగే అవకాశం లేదు. మీకు మోస్ట్ ప్రాబబ్లీ ఇండస్ వ్యాలీ సివిలైజేషన్ నుండి ఒకటే క్వశ్చన్ లేదంటే రెండు రావడం కూడా అసాధ్యం. బట్ ఒకటే క్వశ్చన్ వచ్చే అవకాశం ఉంటుంది. కాబట్టి మీరు ఆ లెవెల్లో అంత లెవెల్లో గ్రూప్ 2 గ్రూప్ 1 లెవెల్లో చదవాల్సిన అవసరం లేదు. కాబట్టి మీరు వాటికి సంబంధించి డెప్త్ అనే పాయింట్ మీద స్ట్రెస్ చేసుకోకండి, దాన్ని వదిలేసేయండి, బ్రీఫ్గా చదవండి.
రైట్. సో సంపత్ అనే కాలర్ అడిగినట్టుగా మనకి హిస్టరీకి సంబంధించి గురుకుల ఉద్యోగాలకి ఎగ్జామ్స్లో ఏ రిలేటెడ్ ఎక్కువ క్వశ్చన్స్ వచ్చే ఛాన్స్ ఉంది?
మనకు ఇండియన్ హిస్టరీ సంబంధించి
ఒక లైన్లో,
ఓకే, ఇండియన్ హిస్టరీ సంబంధించి మనకు 3 ఏన్షియంట్, మిడివల్, మోడర్న్ హిస్టరీ. మనకు మోడర్న్ హిస్టరీలో ఎక్కువ క్వశ్చన్లు స్ట్రెస్ అయ్యే అవకాశం ఉంది. ఆ మోడర్న్ హిస్టరీలో కూడా ఇండియన్ నేషనల్ మూమెంట్ మీద ఎక్కువ స్ట్రెస్ అయ్యే అవకాశం ఉంది.
రైట్. సో హిస్టరీ గురించి చాలా విషయాలు, గురుకుల ఉద్యోగాల కోసం సమాచారం అందించినందుకు థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్ అండి. ఇది ఇవాళ మన టీవీ స్పెషల్ ప్రోగ్రామ్. కీప్ వాచింగ్ మన టీవీ.